Winter is a season loved by some and hated by others. Regardless of how you feel about it, one thing is true. The season is generally punctuated by shorter days, and we can feel it. But we're not the only ones. Plants and animals anticipate seasonal shifts and alter their behavior and physiology accordingly. And it turns out bacteria can too. In fact, recent research shows that cyanobacteria, the oldest photosynthetic organisms on Earth, anticipate the change in seasons by way of their circadian clock. Specifically, exposure to short winter-like days enhances cyanobacterial resistance to cold, a response that lasts multiple generations. What can this tell us about the evolution of so-called photoperiodic timekeeping? And how can we use it to understand the survival of diverse organisms in a changing climate? Welcome to Microbial Minutes, the American Society for Microbiology's update on what's hot in the microbial sciences. I'm Madeline Barron, Science Communication Specialist at ASM. Before we dive into today's video, please take a moment to fill out the survey linked in the description. It only takes a few minutes and helps us make better videos. We appreciate your support. Okay, so to kick things off, let's talk about clocks, specifically circadian clocks. These intracellular clocks, composed of interacting genes and proteins, facilitate daily oscillations in gene expression that regulate an organism's circadian rhythm. This refers to changes in behavior or physiology that follow a 24-hour cyclical pattern, such as, for example, when we get sleepy or when we wake up. Light and dark have the biggest influence on circadian rhythm and clock function, though there are other factors such as food intake and stress that matter as well. While we are quite aware of our circadian clocks and rhythms, and can feel when they get out of whack, humans are just one of many organisms, including plants, mammals, insects, and others, that have them. And bacteria can have them too. If we're talking microbial circadian rhythms, cyanobacteria are the stars of the show. There's been some research into whether other types of bacteria have circadian rhythmicity, both individually and on the scale of communities like the microbiome. However, cyanobacteria, which are ubiquitous in fresh, brackish, and marine water, were the first prokaryotes in which a bona fide circadian clock was discovered, and they've become a model system for studying circadian rhythms. The cyanobacterial circadian clock consists of three proteins, chi A, B, and C, that, depending on lightness and darkness, undergo cycles of phosphorylation and dephosphorylation to regulate a large percentage of the genome and align cellular responses to conditions at the time. But, as we know, the periods of light and dark can change not just on a scale of night and day, but also longer shifts in the form of seasons. That is, how long those nights and days are, which correspond to how the Earth tilts during its orbit around the Sun. The ability of plants and animals to measure differences in night and day length, known as photoperiodic time measurement, or photoperiodism, is key to anticipating seasonal transformations like temperature changes. The result is a trigger of adaptive responses, think hibernation and breeding, that correspond with that season and the environment or resources associated with it. One would think that bacteria, with their hours-long generation times, wouldn't be able to keep tabs on something as gradual as a seasonal shift. Yet, as a recent study shows, that's just not the case. The study, published in Science, was aimed at determining whether cyanobacteria were capable of timekeeping on timescales longer than a day to promote cold resistance responses to seasonal changes. To do this, researchers incubated the cyanobacterium Cynococcus elongatus under 8 continuous 24-hour cycles of short or long days. There were 3 cycles, 8 hours of light, 16 hours of dark, 12 hours of light and 12 hours of dark, and 16 hours of light and 8 hours of dark. After 8 cycles, the bacteria were exposed to ice-cold temperatures and their survival assessed. The way this experiment was conducted, that is, exposing cells to several cycles of light and dark before exposure to cold, is consistent with what happens in nature, where changes in day length precede drastic drops in temperatures. Notably, cyanobacteria exposed to short days, that is, 8 hours of light and 16 hours of dark, survived 2 to 3 times better than those exposed to either equal day or night length or long days, suggesting the bacteria can use the light cues to anticipate the subsequent change in temperature. This response was also dependent on having a functioning circadian clock, as strains of cyanobacteria lacking any of the clock genes did not exhibit enhanced survival. Moreover, the scientists noted that in order for the phenotype to emerge, the bacteria needed to be exposed to at least 4 light-dark cycles over multiple cyanobacterial generations. One cycle was not enough, highlighting that bacteria must sense that there is a shift in the norm. What exactly explains this increased survival? Analysis of the lipids in cells exposed to short days revealed that they had more membrane desaturation. That is, the structure of the lipids in the membrane helps maintain fluidity of the cell membrane in the cold. Gene expression analysis of cells exposed to the 8 cycles of short or long photoperiods revealed altered expression of genes associated with DNA metabolism, temperature, photosynthesis, and stress responses. For instance, in bacteria exposed to longer days, there was an upregulation of stress response pathways associated with light and heat stress, which makes sense. For those exposed to shorter days, the researchers noted an increased expression of metabolic genes known to facilitate survival in darkness. Collectively, the results show that cyanobacteria exposed to winter-like photoperiods survive low temperatures better than those exposed to summer-like photoperiods, with a functioning circadian clock being a key requirement. What's notable about this is that the ability to measure differences in day and night length and respond accordingly may have first evolved in prokaryotes, and much earlier than originally thought. Scientists hypothesize that it evolved from pre-existing pathways geared toward combating stress over a daily cycle, ultimately expanding, along with the evolution of a circadian clock, to anticipate regularly occurring stressors that come with the seasons. The discovery could also have an impact on the here and now. Most people are familiar with cyanobacteria in the form of large blooms that cause environmental and economic problems. The authors of the study suggest that while these blooms are tied to acute conditions like temperature, light, and nutrients, they may also have an anticipatory seasonal piece too, with links to climate change. That is, there may be a mismatch between what organisms are expecting to happen based on daylight cues and what actually does happen in terms of seasonal shifts, particularly for organisms that do not regenerate or adapt as quickly as cyanobacteria. This could be problematic as they are operating on a time scale that no longer fits the environment they exist in. Having a microbial system to study such photoperiodic responses will be invaluable as we try to understand the survival and adaptation of organisms in a changing climate. Now, there's another interesting piece to all this, too, which is that the cyanobacterial response to changes in day length and subsequent survival in cold conditions spans multiple generations, almost like an intergenerational memory. This is not an isolated example. There are many cases in which microbes pass information, or quote-unquote memories, from one generation to the next to promote survival in changing conditions. How exactly the memory response works in the context of this work we covered today needs to be determined. But there are known mechanisms in other prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms, including mechanisms tied to epigenetics, protein accumulation in passage daughter cells, and nutrients. Microbial memory has been shown to play a role in antibiotic resistance, biofilm production, and stress responses. There's still a lot scientists don't understand about the memories of microbes in cyanobacteria and beyond, but learning more could help inform how we use microbes to promote environmental and human health. That's all for today. Please be sure to fill out the survey linked in the description. As always, I want to thank you for listening, thank Ray Ortega for production, and I'll talk to you soon.